Good afternoon, it's the Amateur Science Lab, and welcome back to Kerbal Space Program. Today we are reviewing 1.12, the new update that just released today. I think it's called the Final Approach, but I think it's called the Final Approach. Anyway, enough dilly-dally, let's make a new world so we can show off all the new features this update brings. For the last update of the original Kerbal Space Program, I hope it happens it's a nice update. Alright. First thing on the list. Wait, let me put on get a command pod first, and first thing, firework launchers. KSB 1.12 introduces firework launchers to the game. And I'm not sure where the fireworks are at. Trail type. You can choose classic, whirly, destroyed, bear. I'm not sure. Should we try out all of these? These have been redesigned, I think. They look a bit different. Yeah. Like, these rocket launchers come in two sizes, 32 count or the 8 count, which is obviously smaller. We're going to use 4 8 counts to show off each of the types of... Alright, we're going to have one classic, one whirly, one strobe, and one bear. There's also burst type, classic, blossom. I'm not going to be able to show all these. Palm, rings. Crescent, willow, I'm gonna do crackle for this one. So, I'm not gonna be able to do all of these today, but I don't know, maybe I'll experiment with more. I just opened up Kerbal for the first part, so bear with me, please. Anyways, these do look nice, but moving on to the next, feature, we have the slim spacesuit. Must have taken design from SpaceX's suit, but it looks nice and stylish. Anyways, besides that, honestly, I'm not quite sure what's different, honestly. I'm just gonna finish this rocket. Alright, now that we've built a rocket, now we will go launch it. Now we will go launch the rocket. As you can see, I have added a top and bottom stage, a whole lot of stuff, which I will talk about later, and these firework things. And it is also possible that you could, like, adjust the launch velocity and how long it'll take for it to explode. Wait, I'm gonna just adjust the star size so it's much more spectacular. Anyways, let's try launching one. Let me try that again. Pretty loud. Anyways, let's launch the rocket, and I'm gonna skip this part because it's kinda just a normal launch. So now that we are in that high orbit around Kerbin, we can talk about more features of the game. You know how I detonated some fireworks in the atmosphere of Kerbin to demonstrate it before we got to space? I did it because since space is a vacuum, the fireworks produce no sound in space. Which is a nice detail that the developers added, which makes it closer to real life. Alright, you may have wondered what these things are, and they're solar panels. There are a lot of new solar panels. Some are circular, like these solar panels. These ones you can retract, these ones you can't. And then there are these solar panels. These ones you can retract, and these ones you can't. Outside of the parts that are new, you can see there's a clock on this one. So, obviously they added the Kerbal Alarm Clock mod into the stock game. Which means you could probably go to a long point in the orbit and set an alarm for it. Which honestly I'm not sure how to do yet. Set time to alarm. Let me try doing this. 100 minutes. Add alarm. So there's an alarm right now for that long. And we can use this item. So we can use this icon to show how long that is until. And we can warp until the alarm goes off. So normally you'd have an alarm for like a maneuver node or something like that. Time warp halted. Delete and close. So yeah, which brings us to our next thing, a maneuver tool. Honestly, I'm not really sure how to do this yet. So let's try aiming it for Duna, even though I'm not gonna go there. Position curve it, current orbit. I'm gonna be honest, I have no idea how to do this, but I think it incorporates a mod. This is gonna take more tinkering for me to understand actually how to do this. But they have like a transfer window timing thing. So it tells you how far you are from a transfer window. Or something like that. I think it means it begins at day 5. 5 hours for the moon. I'm honestly not sure. But I'll have to experiment with that further. Yeah, I think that's the time until. The time until the transfer window starts. I can't get the word across. Anyways, let's deorbit because I think I've shown all the features, but I forgot to show one. Let's get Jebediah out of the pod real quick to show off the new suit. magnificent. It kind of does look a lot like the SpaceX suit, and oh yeah, it looks a lot like the SpaceX suit. Alright, let's get him in the back in the vehicle. From here we can see how many absurdly sized solar panels I needed to demonstrate for this video, so that probably caused a lot of drag, but we really don't care. I feel like this is dragging on for way too much, so I'm probably going to crop a lot of this, and therefore I'm not going to even talk. Alright, time to deorbit. Because we're going to be re-entering pretty soon. Also, this is time thing at the apoapsis, and you could probably set an alarm for when the apoapsis is going to happen. Or something like that. So anyway, let's just enter the atmosphere here. Oh wait, the fireworks may burn. I really don't want them to burn, because, you know, I just don't want them to burn. I want to fire off fireworks as we're descending, because it would look pretty cool. So please don't burn to a crisp. Alright, we are pretty good, and we're going to deploy our parachute soon, as soon as it'll let us, as soon as we decelerate ourselves enough. Alright, the chutes have deployed. There goes the debris. Anyways, this is to the 10th anniversary of Kerbal Space Program. I mean, I haven't played the game for the full 10 years that it has existed, but I've certainly enjoyed it throughout the time I've played it. I started playing it in November of 2018, and for my birthday, and yeah, I started playing it on the console, and then I moved to the PC. So it's not like I'm a veteran at the game or anything. I've barely visited the outer planets, but through the time I have played it and the places I've gone in Kerbal Space Program, it's taught me a lot about, like, orbital mechanics and delta V and that kind of stuff, like launch windows and all that spacey stuff that's really hard to cover without outright showing you. Which is why I kind of like Kerbal Space Program, because it gives you a hands-on experience with this kind of stuff, and allows you to create your own ships in the process. It allows you to be creative with these scientific principles. This has also given me like a better amount of respect for all the accomplishments you've had, like sending probes to the planets or going to the moon, and yeah, it's been a great 2.5 years of playing the game. Why is it not deploying? Whoops. I was supposed to deploy a parachute, but it isn't case for you without Kerbal dying in the process, I guess. Anyways, it's been... So, congratulations, KSV, on your 10th anniversary. Well, this is the last update of the original game. We are looking forward to seeing the sequel come out next year. Hopefully, if there's no more delays or anything like that. But it has come a long way since its humble beginnings. It's amassed a huge following throughout the years and inspired a lot of people to pursue aerospace engineering and other stuff like that, and that might include me. Anyways, happy 10th anniversary, Kerbal Space Program. Love, the Amateur Science Lab. The Amateur Science Lab. That's my channel name. And I forgot to capitalize the science, but who cares? This video has been dragging way too long. Anyways, have a great summer. And, I don't know, peace out. This has been the Amateur Science Lab. Have a great summer, I guess. Bye.